Okay, there we go. Hey guys, welcome to Instant Replay Live Stream, Brawlhalla. It's just Nick. Joe is out. He abandoned me to play Magic the Gathering, and my wife Rachael is also out dogsitting, so I'm sitting at home alone and decided to fire up a game, and then I thought, why not see if someone else wants to hang out with me? So, if you guys would let me know before we get too far into this, like, how the sound is, if I'm loud or too quiet, or if the music's too loud, whatever. I'm going to start off with my Baerdvar character here and see if I can't either get my butt kicked or kick some butt online. Sound is a little loud in my headphones, so I'm wondering if anyone else is experiencing the same thing. This is actually just the, that was the loading room there. Now I'm headed into an actual match against someone one-on-one.
3, 2, 1, brawl!
10 out of 10 for sound. Is it balance? Alright, awesome. Thank you, Alex. Jachplays. Is it Jack or Jock? Everyone, no one knows really what to say when we talk about you. We're always uncertain. Ooh, that guy got a good hit on me. This is one of those fun games where it's like, it's pretty intense to try to give commentary at the same time while actually surviving against someone of decent skill. I was hoping my first match would be against someone easier. This guy seems to know what he's doing. if people don't know what this game is, and I am recording this, by the way, so this will be out there for some viewing on the channel, I imagine, at some point. But this is Brawlhalla. It's a platformer brawler game, kind of in the style of, heavily in the style of Smash Bros., but for PC. And man, is it good. Joe and I have been playing the crap out of this. We just love every moment. That guy just suicided on me. it's super tight controls. There's not a lot of fluff or anything to get, like, wrapped up in too much. The levels are simple. The design is beautiful. It's just one of my favorite gaming experiences lately. So, big fan. And I've been playing a lot of ranked online, but this guy's been kicking my butt. I tend to have the most trouble against the character this guy's playing anyway, Lucian. He's just a solidly fast and capable build. All the characters feel balanced, but people seem to do really well against my style with Lucian. I think I might be able to turn this around now. It's going well. Oh. I expected him to jump, not punch me. There's very few, like, it's not like a combo game or anything, but you can do some directional power hits and things like that. It works really well in that regard. You don't have to learn a bunch of complex maneuvers, but really being able to react. And in that sense, it's kind of twitchy, I guess, but being able to just not feel like, oh, someone knows all the combos, I'm screwed, has been a big draw for me coming in as a noob. Well, everyone's a noob. I shouldn't say I'm a noob and anyone else isn't. Oh, this guy's got me juggled. All too well. Oh. This is my last life. I don't want to lose it here. Okay. Alright. Wall hug. Get up here. Get away from him. Oof. Almost. He knows. He knows he's got me. He knows exactly where this is going. I'm one hitting out, and he's not. But oh, there it is. Man. That was tight. That was good. Let me let him know. And on to the next one. And you get a little reward. You get some XP that gives you, like, unlockable skins and stances for your characters and things. So a loss is never really a total loss. It doesn't feel terrible. But it's obviously more fun to win. Baird Var is probably my favorite, even though I just got my butt whooped with him. But I'm going to mix it up. Let's go Hattori. She is super fast and super sweet to play as. I don't have any unlocks for her yet. But hopefully I'll get those locked in soon. Again, this is just loading screen. There we go. Lets you beat up a little bit on each other during the pre-battle battle.
3, 2, 1, brawl!
Hattori's my babe. Too strong, too fast. And sweet animations. I want that mine. Whoops. Didn't want it that way. Oh, he went right over. So yeah, man. There's a couple other people in here. I'd love for them to say hi. Alex, of course, I know well from our YouTube interactions, and I'm so happy you're here. But would love to hear who else is in there. Hopefully people are enjoying it. I know it's just getting started, so early to tell, really, I suppose. If the whole night goes like that first battle, people probably get old of it, tired of it pretty fast. But this one's going a little better, I think. Ducks for feet or feet for... wait. Ducks for feet or feet for duck. I suppose, like if I went outside and, like... first of all, that question comes from Jachplays. If I went outside... and there were just, like, quacking feet hanging out there, that would be terrifying. But stepping on ducks all day would be way worse, so I think I would take the feet for duck. Nonsensical thing. Oh, I just noticed this guy has like a Cap'n Crunch skin with his blue... Whoops. Oh, wasted bomb. Blue pirate. Good hit. Oh boy. All right, give me another question, Jack, since I think I've secured the answer to that one, as happy as I'm going to be. Ah, oh, missed the edge. What's another? Oof. Starting to figure me out. Oh man, that was close. Okay, all right. He's got those downswings down. Yeah, I do know about, Cap'n Crunch's insignia. So here's my thought on that. What navy are we putting Cap'n Crunch in that we can declare what his insignia really is, you know? Like, is he actually a U.S. Navy captain of the appropriate time? What is the appropriate time for Cap'n Crunch? So I kind of challenge the rating. I think you can't call him Cap'n if he's an admiral. So... who to play now? I do like Roland. Why not? I'm on him already. It's convenient.
Sir Roland.
It's warm here and uncomfortable. Stupid summer weather. Joe would yell at me for talking about the weather, but he's not here, so I can talk about it all I want. It's disgusting. I'm sweaty. I'm uncomfortable. I'm just not happy about it. Dang. Rocket Lance is so tough, but so sweet. Feels so powerful to hit someone with that thing. Oof. But like I said, there's not really a character in this game that feels, like, underpowered. They've done amazing things with the balance. Wow. I can't believe I lived. Oh. Okay, alright, just gonna throw. Oof. Oof. Oh, I thought I had that. Hey, Polo. Welcome to the chat. If I can have $1 million every time I see a birthday cake... Wait. The question's a little incomplete. Am I eating the $1 million or am I eating the birthday cake? So I have to eat the birthday cake every time. This leads to so many questions. If I manage to not finish my birthday cake, do I lose the $1 million always? Do I lose the power? Do I lose the $1 million that one time? These details will matter. So, I'll give you 18 seconds to respond to me while I deal with Hattori here. Oof. There we go. All right. Jachplays, what's the story? $1 million every time I see a birthday cake. Do I have to eat the entire cake every time to continue having the power? What's the rules? I have to eat it no matter what, so I'm incapable of stopping. I think I would go with $1 million. That seems worth it. How big is this birthday cake? Is it like a 100-person sheet cake, or is it like a 8-size party cake? Oof. Come on, Tori. Oh, good hit. Good throw. Yeah, there we go. Juggling is such a key element in this game.
Ha ha! Player 2 wins!
Whenever you see any birthday cake, you have to eat it. So you would just live somewhere where you avoid pastry shops. That's a big key. You wouldn't want to get there. Any cake you see, too. Yeah. I think if I had $1 million every time, I could see cakes whenever I wanted and then just avoid them with the money that I have otherwise. So it seems like... a win-win, no matter what. I'm definitely taking that deal. Any other great philosophical debates for us?
Cassidy.
I could ask you guys some, I guess. Would you rather? I have a buddy who's actually he's a good friend of the channel too. He likes to play Would You Rather games, where the answers are not decided by like popular opinion, but by an elaborate narrative he puts together. So I'll see if I can give him a try, doing him justice. Would you rather sell yourself, not sell yourself, dedicate yourself to a life of poverty and employ as a monk in silence, or sorry, trying to live and come up with these is silly. Is there an echo? Do you have maybe it open in two? Oh, you know what? I'll bet you I know how you're getting an echo. Let me see if this is playing at all. Try that now. See if that's any better. So you're either a monk who is living a life of poverty and silence, or you are transported back in time and have to live in the Wild West. Go. Okay, so it was coming from somewhere else. Nice. I have Twitch open, obviously, and another monitor to be able to watch the chat and everything. And I like to just see the stream and make sure there's nothing weird going on with it. So I didn't know if the sound was somehow coming from there, even though I didn't hear it. But I'm glad to hear, no offense, that it was on your end. Yeah, thrown back to the Wild West, vow of poverty, vow of silence. Oh. And the way he does these is he will open the floor for questions about those, and you get points, you'll get points detracted from you if you ask questions outside of the time frame. So I'll open the floor for questions now. All right. So he would say, minus 5 points to PTwitchC for deciding before it was time to decide. But that's just the kind of guy he is. It's not to be taken seriously.
Random.
So I'm guessing you guys have you've locked in. So it would go something like Jachplays chose to become a monk and live a life with a vow of silence and free beer, which he brews in the sanctity of his cloister. However, yeah, turns out that your particular organization of monks does not make beer, but instead survives solely on homemade oatmeal. Alcohol is outlawed, and you have to live the rest of your days without any. However, you did turn out to choose the better choice, because PTwitchC goes back in time as a... as a cowboy in the Wild West, attempts to meet Doc Holliday, his presumed idol of the era, and when he does so, is unfortunately shot through the heart and bleeds out and dies. So Jachplays wins and loses. So, Karen, We're playing a twisted version of Would You Rather, where a single person arbitrates. Yes, shut through the heart, you're to blame. A single person arbitrates your fate based on the choices you make, and usually in negative ways to make you feel like no matter which choice you make, it goes bad. Also, hi and welcome, Karen. Thanks for coming. Oh, and the game on screen is Brawlhalla, which is kind of like Smash Bros, but for PC. Oof. Oh, man. This guy knows what he's doing. Oh, that's cool, I guess. Also, Karen, Joe is not here tonight. He's out playing Magic the Gathering, so you're stuck with just me if you're hanging out. And I'm sorry for it. Oof. Mostly, I'm using this stream as an excuse to level up my characters in ranked matches, but not feeling like I'm completely alone while doing it. So, thank you guys for being here to be a part of that. Oh, and I guess I should say, no, Joe, I'm sorry. Everybody wants Joe. I don't blame you. Oh! Yeah, only half of Instant Replay Live, I'm afraid. And not the better half. Unless Joe were here, and then I would say the opposite. I would. Anytime he can hear. We might get, however, Joe's good friend and my good friend, Redbeard to join us soon and play some Brawl with me. So that could be fun. Yeah, Beautiful Joe would be a fantastic playthrough. I would be happy to be involved in that. Should have hurt that guy more. Oof. Meanwhile, he is wrecking me. I stand corrected when he lands on his own mine. There we go. Is PTwitchC someone I should know who would know Redbeard? Is that a first name P, last name C that I happen to know the name of, one of Joe's friends? Because it sounds like it might be.
Random.
PTC. See, the person I'm thinking of, I don't know the middle name, so I could be. Okay, all right. I had a feeling. I didn't want to out your actual name if you weren't comfortable with it. Well, thanks for coming, man. I appreciate it.
Three, two, one,
maybe I should
roll.
Message after this fight. Message Redbeard and see if we can get him on. Let's see if I can... Oh! Oh. Knock me out of my hit. Oh, good hit. If anyone here has not had an opportunity to play this game, super high recommended list for me. I love it. Ooh. Nice rocket lance battle. boy. Yeah. Wrecked in that. Oof. Yeah, keep spamming. Like, where am I? I was so far up off screen. I was never coming down, it felt like. Now I'm not. Oh, shit. Wrong. Sorry, getting intense. Seriousness is activated. I appreciate that PTC. I think he's actually streaming some right now, but he said he'd be up for co-streaming, so that'll be an interesting experiment. To the rocket battle. This didn't work out well for me last time. Rocket Lance. Ooh. Uh-oh, uh-oh. Could this be it? Yep, yep. That's it.
Player two wins.
All right. Oh, they left, I was going to say. The good old good game, but they're gone. Let me take a break here for just a moment and see if I can get that collab working. Okay, yeah, he is up for it, so sorry for the delay here, but let's get that going. Let me fire up ye old Skype. Let's see what monitor it shows up on over here. Oh. Don't know how this is gonna go with us both trying to stream and all that, but I'll just have to check with you guys, see if you hear him okay and that kind of thing. So reaching out here. Appreciate everybody's patience. Hello, Shigamori. So people are saying you can request keys and whatnot. My copy, I think, came in a Humble Bundle, but there are ways to get free keys. There's actually a thread right now on Reddit where you can request a key, and people are passing them out, so you might be able to get one from there, potentially. I mean, you know, who knows? Who can really say? But I heard from someone else that it will go full free to play, some point. You know what? this is going to disappoint, PTC. I forgot that, we're talking about different Redbeard gamers, and I said Redbeard. That's my fault. And there is Redbeard, and then there's also Redbearded Gamer. And it's so... I'm sorry. I think I have misled you to think the wrong Redbeard was going to be joining me. Oh, dude, totally. Yeah, and thank you for joining the stream here and hanging out. We'll be gaming again in just a minute, so absolutely happy to have hung out with you guys last night. Let's see here. All right, finally getting this call going. Sorry for the confusion. So this is Redbearded Gamer who's going to be getting on. Redbearded Gamer.
Hey, man.
Hey, you are you're on my stream right now, so they should be able to hear you. Just, you know, FYI, don't say anything, you know, you wouldn't want the world to hear.
Okay, good.
Yes, I lied to you, PTC. I'm sorry. I'm reading the stream chat here. So
if you would like, I could get Sally in here as well. We can make it interesting.
Yeah, sure. No Joe tonight, but I'll be up, you know, for a while. So, yeah, you can do that. Do you think they're going to take a while, or do you think they'll be on right away?
Sally's on right now.
Oh, sweet. Hey. Whoa.
Why are you sharing your screen?
Because I accidentally clicked it.
So we've got Redbearded Gamer and Salamander Breath on the stream. You guys want to say hello to everybody?
Hello.
That's such enthusiasm. That's going to win over the crowd.
Hello, everybody.
There you go. That'll do it.
Meh.
Let's see. I guess I'll just make a game.
Adam, I'm in college now, sort of.
Whoa, congrats, guys.
Congrats, Sally.
Guy? Yeah, one guy, I mean. I got a lobby up if you want to join mine.
Mm-hmm. Your lobby is beautiful. All right, let me just... pop my rear right into here.
That's the place for your rear. Right over here. It's terrible. It's no good.
What's new? I don't care. Let's play.
Yeah.
What racing battle game is he talking about?
Oh, Speed Racers. He's talking about you.
Oh, right.
Remembering you from Speed Racers. Yeah, well, that one wasn't a stream, actually. That one was just an episode of our show. But, yeah, it was a good one for sure. That second episode was awesome.
Yeah.
We did the rocket match that you guys suggested and everything else. That was so much fun.
Hey, Sally, by the way, twitch.tv/instantreplaylive, if you want to get in chat.
Oh, yeah, that way you can see what other people are saying. That would be a good call. And then we'll get you in here.
I'm in here.
Welcome to in here.
Hello, follow.
I'm gonna change the. Let's not do timed. Let's do
timed.
This is what I want. Stock lives. Just jack this all the way up because we don't need to worry about that. We have all the time in the world.
Huh.
Damage 100. I don't know why that was up. All right. And I've left us public, so if any random person manages to jump in, that could be fun or interesting. Because it'll just be the three of us, so. Rock on. Choosing a legend.
So, what different skins do you guys have now?
I have Baird Var and the Iron Legion Taros, but that's about it.
I don't have any.
Some colors unlocked, but that's all.
Yeah, I got both of Lucian's skin. They really need to give Lucian more skins, but I got all my weapon skins bought already.
Oh, and that's cool. I should ask for those in the chat: are we hearing Beardy and Salamander Breath? Okay, Beardy
test,
and
test.
Sally.
Sally, 1-2.
So yeah, needless to say, Sally and both of our mutual friends, Chris or Mag, they've been playing this pretty religiously.
Oh yeah,
they're like a level or two higher than me.
Nice. Yeah, I've been having a lot of fun with it. I haven't been playing it too much, but you know, I've been enjoying it. That's for sure.
Gonna move my mouse. Okay.
And good thing this time there's no lag on my end.
Nice.
Good.
Yeah.
We can get that double slice.
That streaming and everything else can, that can cause some trouble. Oh. What a hit. There we go.
Oh, stop.
Oh, nice. That was actually right on. I'm worried that's what this stream is going to turn into. Whoa! Nice. I'm glad everyone can hear. I'm way late on acknowledging that hit the chat like a minute ago. But wow. Wow.
Sorry.
Yeah. By the way, if you got close to getting back up, I was ready to just plow on down and
nice
drive you down into the.
Well, yeah, I didn't have a chance.
Ow.
Jeez.
Oh. My sword.
Ugh.
Get away!
Come here, Sally. With your level 5 thatch.
Yeah, I'm no better.
Okay. Oh.
Oh.
No.
You got that edge. Oh. Oh my gosh, I can't believe you didn't get it.
Well, I mean, I was going for the bomb, and then. Yeah.
You realize death approached?
Yeah. Gotcha.
Well, I am doing terrible anyway, so it doesn't even matter. It's like,
well, I mean, the main thing is just getting a character that you're really, really comfortable with.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
And learning their animations down to the split second like that.
Wow. All right. Deep bomb. Okay.
Woo!
Double-teamed.
No, man. You guys are brutal.
Get off of me!
Oh, I didn't get it.
Oh!
Well, that's it for me. It's on you guys. So now I just get to sit back and watch. So.
Oh! I turned around at the wrong time.
Yeah, it's PTC. It's PTC. It's pretty sweet. The moving levels, especially. Not all of them have. Well, I don't think all of them have moving parts, right?
Yeah, there are only about half of them that have moving parts.
Yeah, I thought so.
And if you haven't caught on already, this is a Smash Bros. Like brawler, The more you get hit, the farther you go.
And also, the more damaged you are at the time you get hit, the more impact it has too. So that keeps things interesting when you're right on the edge but still managing to survive somehow.
Oh, you can also activate the beta maps as well.
Oh, are there new maps that are in there?
In the options?
Yeah, I know how to get to it, but are there actually new maps now?
Not officially, but they do work.
I see, I haven't seen them, yeah.
Yeah, they pretty much all they are hitboxes with stretched out JPEGs over them.
Oh, weird.
Yeah. So far, until they...
Yeah, but like them. But like all the mechanics and levels work, like the moving parts, and they're fleshed out, it's just they don't look as pretty as these.
Yeah, these do look great, though.
Yeah, this one is my least favorite.
Everyone says that. I'm down with this level, man. I'm into it.
It's just there's not enough platforms to stand on whenever you have, like, four people.
Yeah, I could see with four, but... Oh, God, I killed myself. I could see with four this being an issue. But I think at three it's not, you know, overly bad. I think it works. I mean, there's three platforms, right? You can always spread out that much. Plus, I don't like the levels where you can hide off to the side. Like, you know, oh, I'm just going to let them fight over there while I, you know, wait for the stock to run out.
Oh, like me? Like me just then?
Yeah, that's wimpy. I don't dig that.
Okay.
Yeah, I called you out. Come on.
All right, let's do it.
You want some?
Yeah, there.
Yeah, I want some.
Oh, I got hit by your random bullshit over here. Oh. That's shitty. I'm coming for both of you now. It's on.
Okay.
Y'all better carry the stream, because shit's on.
All right, Sally, let's do this. Oh. Yeah, Hattori is brutal sometimes.
Yeah, she's so fast.
Ah. Okay. Not fast. Okay. Faster than me.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Hattori is freaking quick, dude.
Could not have.
Steal.
Come on. Really? Okay.
Oh.
Oh.
That was a bomb.
It didn't matter. All right, there you go.
Hello.
Now it's down to the two of you.
Okay. All right. Freaking Throwmaster over there.
Hey, welcome, Crazy 296.
What's going on, bro? Oh God.
Uppercut you in the midairs.
Yeah, that Titan is freaking awesome. It just looks so impressive, and it sells so much of, like, the greater world without any kind of text or anything else. It's just like, yeah, stuff like this exists.
I don't even look in the background on most of these.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Oh, had you not noticed that before?
No, because I'm focused.
Oh,
on
my God. Fire. Yeah, I love it. I'm locked in on it. It's so good.
Ow!
Stop being a little whiny.
Yeah, he's so good at, like, just making noises and saying, no, I'm out.
I know my animations for Lucian.
Yeah, Lucian's an awesome character. I mean, really, they all are. They really all are. But he's an impressive character sometimes.
Oh, no!
Oh, not looking good, though, Lucian.
Time to juggle. Oh, no.
You guys are pretty evenly matched, maybe.
Nope.
Oh!
I was able to stay up high enough.
Oh, yeah. That was great.
Gotta be kidding me. Wow.
All right, let's bring out my Iron Legion Taros. Oh. Oh, Jachplays is asking the tough questions. Would you rather end world hunger or have a actual working lightsaber?
Lightsaber, for sure.
World hunger's been a problem for many a years. I'd rather go with the lightsaber.
Man.
Well, I mean, to tell you the truth, the one thing that we really need to do to solve world hunger is just to go to a different planet. And I heard a couple days ago that they found a very compatible...
oh, really?
Earth-like planet. It's like 1.6 times the size of Earth. It is approximately the same distance from the same size sun as us. It's got the same type of gravity and all that. I'm not sure if it has an atmosphere or not, but I heard about it a couple days ago.
It's exactly like Earth, but there is no atmosphere.
Yeah.
So,
well, I mean, that can be rectified.
Right. Yeah. That's true for sure.
I mean,
that's pretty interesting.
Yeah. I mean, just as long as the Uh-oh. The planet is pretty near to this pretty near enough to a star,
yep.
It should be fine.
I am terrible. I just went right over the edge.
And the year span on that thing is like 385 days or something.
Ooh.
Yeah. PTC has the good point. You do have to be force sensitive to properly wield a lightsaber.
Yeah.
But
did I say that I'm not force sensitive? Because totally could be. You don't know.
Yeah, I that's right. I don't know you. Oh, I thought one of you guys would jump. yeah, I heard on Reddit, so my sources are not at all verified, but that there's some ridiculous number in the millions of planets estimated to be similar to ours.
Oh yeah.
Throughout our galaxy, that, you know, it's all an estimate, but it's just like,
well, I mean,
look, statistically speaking, you know, like,
well, I mean,
there has to be,
right? Because there's
right.
There's,
yeah.
There's literally a Googleplex of planets.
Right.
Yeah.
Man, Lucian, dodging everything I'm bringing.
Yeah, I know all the animations and I know the jump height.
I had the perfect, then, like, series of swings, and there you're just right. Oh, swing. That was great! I knocked you into his throne hammer. Oh, love it.
Oh! Yep, that's me.
Whoops, I didn't realize I was the one doing thrown there.
Okay, thank you. Have a nice day!
Whoop! Ah!
Oh, somebody in chat said that you're a bastard.
Well, yeah, Joe said, but Joe's a bastard, so... he shouldn't be off playing Magic the Gathering with a bunch of nobody. it's cool. He's out doing the Magic the Gathering thing and meeting some people, so that's sweet. But I'm not gonna let my life go on hold while he's gone.
I can't tell who I'm hitting.
You were aiming at Lucian, and I was aiming at you.
I'm not sure if I've if you and me have talked about, like, if we talked about it during our recording session, but I think one cool thing that they could add is the ability to add hitboxes to thrown items, to where you could, like, hit the items.
Yeah,
back.
You mentioned that, actually, yeah. Yeah, that would be neat. Oh God! Let me just jump into everything you throw my way.
Ooh.
Yeah, but that would be my dream, because normally, like, in most games, I'm good with trajectories and stuff, so if I can get the timing down on all the thrown items from Sally, that would decimate his whole play style.
Oh yeah. Oh. So throwing things at you is what I need to start doing then.
Yeah. I cannot handle
essentially
things being thrown at me.
The IRL origin story. it's too deep and too painful to relive and share, Jachplays. I can't handle it.
Cassidy.
I don't want to be him again. I was him already.
Actually, you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna switch up.
Yeah, I feel that's something I feel like compelled to do in these fighting games is not stick with the same character all the time. Just because, like, it feels more exciting to switch it up. We've got another player.
Nitsta.
Let's just tell Nitsta.
Level 8. Jesus, a level 8 Hattori. Alright, you know what? I'm going back to Lucian.
Okay. Yeah. I just want to let them know that... oh, okay, good. Nitsta's in the stream. Sweet.
Okay.
Well, then we can actually talk to Nitsta. Nitsta, are you on Skype? Do you have a decent mic? Would you like to be on the stream? I mean, you're on the stream regardless, but would you like your voice to be on the stream? Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Mayan pyramids. Get off of here, Thatch.
Yeah, so by the way, you probably have a big target on your head since you're the streamer, so...
Oh, that's nice.
Wait. Yeah, that's the one fun thing about being a streamer on games where other people can join. Is that you'll have a target pin on your back the whole time.
I like it. I'm into it.
Yeah, but... she's coming for me.
Yeah, see? She doesn't...
From experience think. Games.
Okay, really? Yep.
We'll have to, between matches, give Nitsta a chance to... Yeah. Join the call if they want to. Whoa, watch out for that Cassidy bomb! Oh, Lucian!
From downtown!
Don't play the race card, huh?
Anyhow, Lucian.
Ow!
Whoops!
Ow!
All okay. The problems in the world.
Yeah, that was definitely a good assist. You threw your sword, it hit me, and then
nice.
Sally had enough time to get me out of the map. Oh!
Ow!
That was so close. Ow.
Sorry.
See, I don't know. Sorry. What's always Boom! Weird is, like, I have no idea who Nitsta is, though.
Yeah.
Like, is it a random person on the stream, or is it, you know, someone I know who just has a username I don't recognize? That's strange. This internet thing is weird, y'all.
What is internet?
I don't know. I heard about it.
Ah!
Whoa, whoa.
Oh god, oh god, oh god. Oh god. Ow.
Incoming!
Dang it! Come here. Alright, here we go, here we go. Alright, that didn't do anything at all. Now I have no weapons.
Good job.
Boom. Gotcha. Once you learn the animations, you're a force to be reckoned with.
Yeah, oh sure.
Ow! Really?
But you still can't beat random luck. You know, like... Oh, I wonder if I just do this attack here at... Oh, there's an enemy! You know, like... You never know when that's going to pay off in meaningful ways. Oh.
Ow. Ow.
Oh.
Okay, so... This person has two lives, we only have one. Do you want to...
Oh, that... Yeah, all right.
Throw your weapons! It always works!
Ow! No, okay, well, it's all you.
Okay.
Fist fight!
I would go down for it, but there's no way to communicate that right now.
Yeah.
So.
You actually have a pretty decent amount of viewers right now, man.
Well, you know, I mean, everything's relative, right? Like, two of them are you guys, so...
I mean, that still leaves, like, almost
nah, you never know, like, any of that. I don't worry about that. It's not worth worrying about.
I got a new color.
Oh,
sunset.
Nice. Ooh, that's a good Halloween color. Halloween pattern, Lucien.
Let's see.
Oh, yeah, let's give Nitsa a chance to join the call.
I think that color looks best on pirate version. Let me get the right gun.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, and then see, we've got Shigamori, who's just a spam viewer bot. So. So. It's all good.
No microphone.
Oh, that is a shame.
Yeah, that's definitely one thing I like about Hitbox over Twitch. Because that 30-second delay there would not have been there on Hitbox.
Oh, sure. Yeah, yeah. I think we'll probably experiment with Hitbox at some point, but I just already have this all set up, so I went with it.
I got you. I mean, it's
doing
it's,
what's
it's,
easy.
I got you. But it's just the fact of it's the same basic setup anyway.
Mm-hmm.
You got your stream key, and then you can either... with certain programs you can even link up to Hitbox.
Oh sure. Yeah, no, I figured. I just didn't have anything already, you know, set for it, and I can just click a button and go with this, so
yep.
Down with the Twitch. For now. For now. None of it. Yeah, and then there's also YouTube gaming coming, you know. Ooh.
I'm not even gonna get close to that.
No?
Because what if YouTube gets taken out of the picture soon? I don't want to have all my eggs in one basket.
Yeah.
Yeah, if I can even talk while I'm trying to beat all of you up at once. Where? Oh, there I am. We're all like shades of orange. This is ridiculous.
Well,
I know.
I mean, I'm red, but...
It's still orange enough whenever you're...
Yeah, away. Yeah. I could have been more orange is what I'm saying. There were options available to me.
Oh, that was a good hit. Ooh, ow, ow.
Oh, oh, oh.
Ow.
Lol.
Dang it.
Ow.
I thought I was going to be able to jump off of that Hattori there. Is Nitsa playing Hattori again?
Yeah.
Just happy to be the same. Oh, that bomb. That was a target-rich environment. Somebody should have gotten hit.
Yeah, I was just waiting on you to waste that.
Thanks, man.
Oh!
I was just waiting on you to die from that.
Oh, okay. What the hell just happened? I'm so confused right now. This is definitely just ridiculous with four people.
Yeah, this map, four people, it's so tight. But you know, it's so enjoyable too. Like, I'm having a blast. It's...
Someone stand on that. Yes!
No! I came down! And I just missed the hitbox on that, and then Hattori came up and nailed it. God damn it.
Damn it. All right.
Help me, Hattori.
PTC is asking, would you rather live one life that lasts 1,000 years, or the or live 10 lives that last 100 years each?
So you're talking about the a doctor like situation here?
Well, I mean, yeah, you're talking about regenerations, but his lives are not limited to
100 years, right?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it all depends on
what happens during his life. Yeah.
It all depends on what the Time Lord's role is.
Whoa, I won.
I wasn't even paying attention for the last 30 seconds, so yeah.
Yeah, I didn't even know.
I was getting into deep philosophical thoughts.
Sure. Yeah, Radical Ed Girl is asking some great questions there. Also known as Cat Bunny and our Twitter feed handler. Do you remember anything from those previous lives? Do you live them consecutively, or are they at the same time?
Are you the same person, or would you get different personalities?
Oh, no memories of the past lives. See, that pretty much tears it for me. If I had memories of the past lives, then I'd be in. But if I get no memories, then I think I have to go one life to 1,000 years. Because I want to accrue 1,000 years of knowledge. That sounds amazing.
Would that be in a world where everyone would live to 1,000, or?
It's a good question.
Because I like you guys, and I don't want to see you guys die. You know.
I think. I think you would have normal human aging is stretched to 1,000. Okay.
You know, I love how this one question has turned into like 50.
Yeah, well, but that's great. Yeah, that's the mark of a good question. I think if there's a conversation that can branch off of it, I'm all for it. I just had a thought. So PTC thought I was talking about a different Redbeard in our lives when I brought you up, and I kind of was because I kind of said the name wrong. But I wonder if he is available and we could get two of you in the same place at the same time.
No, it'd be like the Superman complex.
Right? That would be so crazy.
But Clark Kent is Superman. Superman is Clark Kent.
PTC, I choose one life, 1,000 years. And if I could charge you with reaching out to Redbeard and see if we can get him on this call, that would be fantastic. I would like to know what happens when the two meet.
Oh.
Does the universe end?
Oh, should have let it go a second earlier. Gotcha. All right, bye.
I really need a weapon. I think I've only had fists and bombs the entire match.
Well, I mean, Sally can do a lot with fists.
Oh! That spear throw was bullshit.
Was that from Sally?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It came from above screen and landed on my head. It was amazing, but it also killed me.
Yeah. He'll do that from time to time. God damn it. Leave me alone. Jesus.
I'm just hopping off of each of your heads.
Hey, oh. Well, here comes another one. And I died. because of that.
Gotcha. Oh, got me.
Go.
That was a good one.
Starting to come into my own, I think. Oh, God, those drops. The spear drops, man. God damn it, Sally.
Yeah, that is definitely one of my taglines.
Yeah. God damn it, Sally.
She has to stay up in the air.
Oh. I do not know Ada's pistols yet.
Ada's pistols are pretty fun.
Oh, don't Jesus. Throw that shit at me. Oh, no!
Throw that at you, then.
Oh, God, what do I do? Okay. What do?
I'm sorry, there's stuff going on in the chat that I'm not paying attention to while I try frantically to survive.
Yep, I'm out.
Nice!
Wings or Superman flight?
Wings.
Superman. Like, why would you want wings that are going to be obvious for everyone to see and probably get you like branded as a both social pariah and freakish creature that needs to be experimented on?
Well, I mean, all right, let me combine. Leave me alone, let me answer the question, stop hitting me.
I mean, death comes for us all.
okay, well, I'm gonna go back to a previous question and tie everything together. Hawkman.
Yeah, he's badass. No doubt.
Yeah, but just the wings, no abilities. Yeah,
right, exactly.
I'm adding into the question.
it's interesting, but I don't think it's in the spirit of the question.
Sure.
You don't get extra lives just for picking wings.
Who said?
Well, I guess it's up to PTC, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, have you ever had wings?
That's true, I haven't.
You don't know if pigeons have multiple lives. maybe they got it backwards all this time. Maybe pigeons have 9 lives instead of cats.
Whoa.
You just blew Sally's mind.
My mind is blown.
Be philosophical here. Jesus.
Oh, shit.
Why are there so many pigeons? Because they have 9 lives. They never die.
Oh, no.
Oh, God, yep.
Wow.
Pigeons in New York, they know they can die, so they just hang around the humans.
I mean, me, I'm way more of a Flash fanboy and a Green Lantern fanboy than I am Superman or Hawkman and Hawkgirl.
Oh, no. I don't like Superman at all. And yeah. I do agree that wings look way cooler than just being able to Superman fly. So yeah. No doubts about these facts. They are facts. But, shit, hang on, let me not die. While these things are true, I still have a life to live, you know? So, I think definitely Superman
yeah, but there,
flight.
There would have to be some...
Shit.
counter to it, though. I mean, you may be ugly with the wings, but, like, what would be the defect of the Superman flight?
Well, I mean... If you get his speed, you wouldn't have his invulnerability, which would lead to you wind shearing.
But he controls his speed well enough that you could fly slower. You just wouldn't want to go top speed.
Well, then why would I? I would want wings if I wasn't going to have the speed.
Would it be like the wings? Like it takes up energy, so you have to eat a lot.
Oh boy! Hey guys, Kraken Quake Gaming is here. Hey, Kraken Quake, can we get you on the call? Sorry, I shouldn't have interrupted the conversation because it's going to be 30 seconds before he hears that. So...
Okay, sorry, PTwitch. It was actually from Jachplays, and it was rather be able to fly or be invisible.
Oh, yeah, we totally looked at PTwitch's question and not the other. Fly or be invisible. Well, in that case, then, there's questions about do you fly safely, or do you have to deal with, like you were saying, wind shear, and even just like a bug or a bird hitting you at, you know, a decent speed could really wreck your day. Do you have to worry about those things, or are you okay? Because if you're not okay, I think probably got to go with the invisibility.
Yeah, I mean, invisibility to me, that's a B-list superpower.
It is, but safety first.
I'd rather be able to fly.
All right. Yeah.
Because, I mean, flight is closer to super speed than invisibility. So that's just me.
Well, let's see what Jachplays says. Also, before we start this fight, we're going to see if we can get the other Redbeard on the call just so you guys can talk.
Beard-to-beard conversations.
Beard-to-beard. Well, specifically Redbeard. This is already a beard-to-beard conversation, but but specifically two Redbeards.
Yeah. If you want to go into the settings and activate the...
Oh, yeah. Why not? We'll do some goofy maps.
It's down at the bottom.
I got it on now.
Well, I mean, Taya, it would all depend on... Oh, I mean, if it was unlimited energy that you could use to do the telekinesis, then yeah, sure. But if you had to use energy for that, I wouldn't want telekinesis either. For me, my ultimate superpower, like metahuman superpower, would be zero speed, and then any superpower would be a power ring from the Green Lantern Mythos. On any of the emotional spectrum cores, to be honest.
That went over my head because I was talking and typing or typing at the same time while you were talking. But what I would say is my choice power, period, always when this question comes up, is complete time control, right? You need to be able to stop, start, rewind, fast forward the whole nine yards and be unaffected by aging during these changes, but still able to interact and, you know, experience things. Like if you stop time, it doesn't just stop time forever for everyone, including yourself. But if you had total time control, what could ever get around that? What could ever be better? How do you defeat something that has total time control?
Well, the Flash has beat Zoom so many times.
You know, that's a good call, actually, Zoom, because Speed
Zoom
Force...
Zoom has the power of time control. The Flash and every other speedster in the DC Universe has draws from the Speed Force.
Yep, and can break time. You're absolutely right. So that's a good call. Speed Force level powers of speedsters. That is a good call. But I'd still choose time control.
Yeah.
Because I wouldn't be a villain. Right. So control weather or earthbending are high on superpower list. Yeah. Definitely control weather. That's the other one that I think is like my number two right after speed time control is weather control.
Well, for me it would be water bending or air bending, not earth or fire.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and throw us into the next match because it looks like Redbeard is Crack and Quake Gaming is redownloading Skype, so we'll get them on next time, and yeah, just do one of these fun things. That's a weird looking map. It's gonna be fun.
Yeah.
Whoa, it looks so bad.
Yeah, it's just the hitboxes. Oh, who am I? Oh, I'm Cassidy, okay. I forgot that I chose random.
Yeah, same.
Oh, I like the elevator.
Yeah.
Watch out for that bomb!
Ow. I just want to... Okay. Please, can I please? Can I just... Thank you.
Oh, my platform disappeared! Oh, yeah. Bullshit!
Yeah, this map is ridiculous.
Oh, damn. I did not see that coming.
Who's Hattori? Sally, are you Hattori?
Yes.
Of course you are. Because
I'm throwing?
No, because our random chose Roland.
Oh.
And I had to think for a minute. Because, you know, I'm not good at thinking.
Well, yeah, he's not a random. He's from the stream, so... Or he or she, we don't even know. We have no information about this person.
Ow. Okay, I deserve that one.
Nitsta, we want to learn more about you, like the appropriate pronunciation of your name, for starters. If you can hear this while you're playing.
I'm just going to call him Jared from now on.
Jared? Yeah. He went to Jared.
Oh. Ow.
I do not know Queen Nye's. Oh!
Queen Nye is fun to play.
Yeah, she seems powerful. I love her animations too, with those crazy purple spectral powers. Oh, I got.
Yeah, I think for me it's like my characters in this game would have to be like Roland, Queen Nye, Lucian, obviously, and pretty much any of the gun wielding.
Yeah. I like Roland. My favorite is definitely Bodvar. Then probably Scarlet and who's the other girl I like? Hattori. Yeah. But I don't know Hattori that well, but I like her because she's fast.
Yeah.
I need to play her more.
Ow! Okay, I deserve that one.
Don't wait for me.
Ow, okay.
Quit dodging me. All these twirling spears.
Oh, ow.
Barack Obama's in the chat, so I'm guessing Tia the Olive is Nista. It seems that's my assumption from reading half of the chat because I'm there. We go. Now I'm dead. I can read it. First of all, I'm Nista, and yeah, you're getting the name right. All right, a little bit sassy. And then, secondly, I suck at Roland. It's okay. I suck at all the characters. And finally, I'm the President Barack Obama. Well, it is. It's wonderful to welcome the POTUS to the Switch. To the Switch? To the Twitch. to either one of these things. And thank you for playing with us, too. It's super cool. It's a lot of fun.
Hey-o.
Nice.
Hey-o. 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 Oh.
I'm sorry you couldn't get on the call and join it with us, but just appreciate you hanging out. Do we... Nitsta, do we know you from somewhere, or did you just kind of stumble on us? How'd you get in here? Oh, good. Redbeard, aka Crack and Quake Gaming, is available for Skyping now. Surprised I don't have him already on here. I think I have to friend him first. Let me do that.
Oh, I know what I want to do. Hey, Sally. Hattori.
Are you both going Hattori? I'll go Hattori. Just because. Yeah, half of Crack and Quake will be on here. Sorry. All right. Can I add? Where's my active call? Here it is. Add him now.
Yeah, this is gonna be horrible.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it pretty seriously. Okay, two Redbeards are about to collide, possibly mate, live on Instant Replay.
Live.
Oh, we're like the Power Rangers, guys.
Yes, I'm the Blue Ranger. Blue Ranger's the best Ranger.
Oh. Well, I'm the most true Yellow Ranger, so...
That's racist.
I'm just saying! cool. Well, I'm glad you found us on Reddit. That's sweet.
Can you guys hear me?
Yes. Hey! Look at that. Two red beards. my Ow. God. Is it as glorious as you two hoped?
I don't even know what's going on.
So we have red bearded gamer and we have red beard from Kraken Cake. Crap.
Kraken Cake, I love that.
I'm sorry. Kraken Quake Gaming.
Oh, I died.
In the same call. Maybe you two were actually like supposed to be twins and grow up together and things like that, but you could have had some sort of accident at the hospital. Were either of you adopted or anything like that?
I'm not sure.
Well, neither of my brothers has a glorious red beard. So.
Oh my God, this theory has credence.
Oh God.
Oh.
Yeah, sorry I'm not being more talkative to my long-lost twin, but I got Hattori's to beat up.
Yeah, this is a crazy Hattori battle. We've got four Hattori's and two Redbeards. What could be better?
Do you guys have a slot open in the...
Unfortunately, we do not. We are full, which is the shame. I wish we could have gotten you in and actually done that.
You could leave if you want.
I wouldn't dare ask anyone to leave.
Sally, don't beat that guy.
I can stay on the sides. It's not like I'm not important.
Oh shit, I threw a bomb nowhere.
But nowhere is somewhere to somebody.
I killed someone down off the edge of the map. Just dropped the bomb straight down to nowhere.
Somebody yeah, it's like a whole village. It's a whole village down there, you just destroyed it, that bomb.
You just killed Simba on Pride Rock in the background.
So,
oh yeah, that does look like Lion King back there, doesn't it?
Oh yeah, it sure does. So prior to this this call, you two were linked through my brother, Joe. Do you think he is collecting red bearded friends for some nefarious purpose?
He is obviously trying to. I'm dead. Okay, so now I can talk. He's obviously trying to figure out the purpose behind Stonehenge, because anyone with a red beard, it's very possible they have Irish or Scottish ancestry.
Oh,
it is a well-known fact among my friends that red beard is contagious.
Whoa!
Several of my friends and roommates that I've lived with or spent time with after some amount of time, they contract red beard to some degree.
I'm very curious about what that means.
It's like a really bad rash.
Real talk though, before I was like two, talk. I had like 17 different hair colors, and my mom
nice.
Has pictures of me with like extremely red hair.
So
specific.
Oh. Nice.
Yeah, it was pretty ridiculous. So I have blonde hair, which fades into reddish brown in my beard.
So is it possible that you contracted red beardedness as a child?
You know, it all depends. I don't know how long he knew Joe, but Joe might have contracted it and given it to me.
Yeah, Joe could be a carrier of red beard genes. Actually, we do have a redhead in our family, and occasionally I get random single red beard hairs just out of the blue. So, yeah, we could be carriers. We're daywalkers. Who is this other Hattori? Which one is live?
I'm red.
All right. Red. Oh, you're red Hattori. Oh.
Couldn't you figure out from him throwing shit at you all the time?
Oh, I should have. I should have been more aware.
Like my feet, eat my feet.
Damn it!
Ow!
Damn it! Damn it! Oh boy! Woo!
Hey, old
here
bomb.
Comes that bomb! Oh.
All right.
Well, I hope tonight is the start of a beautiful friendship for you two, for the rest of your days.
No, I already hate him.
There can only be one.
Okay, that's the other way this could go, I guess.
He shall be my mortal
oh,
enemy.
Oh, god damn it.
We will fight like champions on a mountaintop one day.
Yeah! I am the superior Hattori.
Bring my katana.
Literally, there can only be one Hattori.
Yeah, only one Hattori, only one Redbeard. That's the way it's going to be, I guess. Oh, see, PTC says that Joe has secretly been planning this all along to get you two to join your beards and form a beard baby.
Mm.
Yeah. Is that what is the likelihood of us seeing that? Is that something we can arrange?
Anyone remember that episode of Dexter's Lab with the beard? Like,
yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yes.
And they, like, joined their beards together, literally.
Well, here we go. We've got precedent for it. Clearly, science has proven it.
Or Gitty Tartakovsky.
Okay. All right, so Pillars is another map that just has a couple of different platforms that don't move.
Well, Redbeard, I will say that you are more than welcome, by far, to stay on the thing. I just had to get the two of you to talk at least once. but it's up to you whether you want to continue hanging out or whatever. Totally, like I said, more than welcome to stay on here. I don't want to bore you or occupy your whole night, though.
I'll stay in the chat for a bit.
Sure.
And right now, I'm not even seeing things that are happening
as you hear them. Yeah,
yeah.
That's what I was thinking about, actually. I was like, man, is this just awkward for him? So I didn't want to be like, get out, but also I don't want to force you.
Thanks
stay.
For inviting me on.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry we didn't have, you know, room. I just killed myself. I'm sorry we didn't have room to bring you in.
We'll do something together soon.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
I did find my key for Brawlhalla, and it still works. So.
Oh, sweet. And, of course, I should have plugged properly for everyone. Sally and Red Bearded Gamer have a YouTube channel that we've done some... Or YouTube channels that we've done stuff with. And you can find them there. And you can also follow Crack and Quake Gaming, because you guys have just started doing your Twitch streaming thing.
Yep.
So everyone in here can follow and be on the lookout for when those guys are doing stuff. We were hanging out with them last night for Tales of Zillia.
Right.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. So.
I'm not sure how long you stick around, but we did finally beat that boss if you...
Oh, nice. Yeah, I saw you fighting it, but I had to go before that was over, so I didn't...
It took us, like, an hour and a half.
Jeez.
Sorry, I was reacting to something in the game.
Oh, no problem.
It's cool. But yeah, I'll catch you guys around, and I'll be in the chat.
Awesome. Yeah, all right, we also have a new question from PTC.
Real quick, though.
Real talk.
I also have a Hitbox channel.
Oh, yeah.
Hitbox.com/redbeardedgamer. You guys can go follow that, and I'm going to be streaming on there pretty regularly. I mean, yeah. Not like once a week or anything, but ow.
Yeah, we were watching you do Minecraft the other day. That was fun as well.
But yeah, while he was talking about his adventures last night, I was like halfway off the map, and then a bomb, like a mine, came within inches of me.
Oh, nice.
Guess whose bomb that was?
Yeah, right?
I saw it, I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna get him.
If it was...
I mean, I saw it, and I think I was able to get myself out of the way of it before it actually hit.
Yeah.
Oh, but it was so close.
If it was thrown from nowhere near your attacker, you know, like, then it must have come from Sally. Yeah, what was I talking about before?
you're talking about the question in chat.
Oh, right. I'm sorry, I got sidetracked. All right. If you could have a scaled to human size animal body part that isn't a sex organ, getting out that out of the way.
Neck.
Okay. what an image. It's just you with a fucking
what?
Long neck.
Sorry, I was concentrating.
Sally wants a giraffe neck. what? You wouldn't be able to get in cars or fit in most houses.
Yeah,
but I can reach the apples.
But you would be one of the most famous Battlefield 3 glitches.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I mean, any freakish, I guess, appendage like that, neck or whatever you do, is going to make you, like, super famous, right? Yeah. Like, if it was giraffe-sized length, it would be insane.
Okay, I got one.
Okay.
Wins.
Yeah. Oh, my God. All right, well played. Well played. All right. I choose the Wolverine's regeneration. That's a thing, right?
No. Animal.
A Wolverine's an animal.
Real Wolverines don't regenerate.
Jeez. Lizards.
Gosh, what do I pick?
Toenails.
Lizard regeneration.
Toenails.
Retractable toenails.
Oh, mantis shrimp eyes is a good answer there.
Isn't the mantis shrimp like the one you can see like 162 colors?
Yeah, yeah. So you would get all kinds of new colors that normal people can't see. I almost think that would be
Smurlable? You pie?
That's the new color out.
I think that would be overstimulating though.
Crayola's making a whole new color.
I almost think it would be the wrong idea to go with that. Because how would you like interact with normal people if you could see an entire spectrum, many spectrums they can't even see? Okay.
Sorry, I was caught up in something. What was the question?
I don't even remember. No, if you pick the mantis shrimp eyes, which admittedly is super cool, how could you relate things to normal people?
It would be like explaining colors to a blind person.
Yeah. God, that'd be both amazing and but horribly upsetting.
But the blind people are people who can see.
Yeah, somebody, Shigemori has pointed out that it would just really be more like explaining it to colorblind people, not the blind.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Except there are, like, gases that are invisible to us that are in other color spectrums, right? Like, would we be able to see them? Like, and in that case, it is more like being blind because it's out of spectrum entirely. God damn it. Oh, no.
You should be able to reconnect. Your character's still here. He's just in AI mode.
Okay.
And we'll try not to pick on him too much.
Okay. It's trying. I'm still getting errors.
Yeah, keep away.
All right, I'm going to cancel out because it's not working to go back in, but I'll try to join you guys.
All right. I don't know who's host after that.
I can't join party either. And spectate isn't working. I lost it.
Well, the one person that we need to be...
I'm back! Am I?
Okay.
Oh, I think I'm spectating now. Hold on.
Ow!
Is it NPC'd me?
Yeah.
All right, that's all right. I can spectate. Is it paused now? What's going on?
No.
Am I having issues?
You're having issues.
What a good way for a stream to go.
I mean, it would be perfect.
Well, I mean, honestly, it doesn't matter what you're doing, just as long as you're interacting with the viewers.
Yeah, I'm sure. But technical issues are always...
Go make a grilled cheese sandwich.
Lesson, and just tell everyone about it. Yeah. Well, I actually did have a grilled cheese sandwich for dinner, and let me tell you, it was from Five Guys product placement.
Ooh. I've never had them.
Five Guys is amazing.
They well,
me... ow.
I'm not amazing, so I can't eat there.
Obviously.
What a life. Ooh. Are you guys in the lobby, or where are you?
We're still fighting.
Yeah, all right.
We're still fighting, and Bear DeVar is still just running around. He's actually just not even trying to hit anyone. He's so depressed that his master left him.
So for some reason, I am staring at Salamander Breath Wins.
Oh, is it telling the future? Are you going to place bets?
I honestly think it might. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and hedge the bets now, and we'll find out if my console has somehow slipped out of time. Not console, my PC. And I'm witnessing end events.
Oh my god! Well, I'm out.
It's okay.
He's dead. Oh
yes.
So I'm not.
What?
what must have happened is I've slipped into an alternate timeline. Clearly, right?
Like, it's the problem with these pre-release games nowadays.
Slipping into alternate timelines.
Sometimes the game breaks, and sometimes you get slipped into an alternate reality, and sometimes, just sometimes, you see the Rise of the Machines. Not the Terminator movie, the actual Rise of the Machines.
Okay,
can you join now? I mean, it says you're in the lobby.
Oh, I didn't even notice that it said, Nitsa said that if you need me to leave, make room. Sorry, but no, we wouldn't want to kick anyone out. That wouldn't be right, so we're happy to have you, Nitsa. No one. Are you guys in the lobby now?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm in the lobby. All right, we're back. Welcome back to Instant Replay Live.
From outer space.
Well, I didn't get to play Bairdvar, so I'm going to go back to Bairdvar since that didn't work out.
That sad look upon your face. Have you heard that LeBron James is going to be in Space Jam 2?
I guess he's kicking off an acting career, right? He's got Trainwreck going right now. I don't know that I care.
Yeah, I think I'm host. I'm not gonna watch it because the only Space Jam that really counts is the Michael Jordan Space Jam.
I'll not go so far as to say I won't watch it. I'd probably watch it. I'm certainly not gonna go to the theater to see it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But yes, Michael Jordan Space Jam is the only Space Jam that should ever matter. Really, I mean. Everything that came first in our time is better.
Yeah, of course. Like the Jurassic Park movies, the Star Wars movies.
Yeah. I was going to say, the Star Wars movies didn't come in our time, but...
Well, I mean...
But they came first.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Star Wars and Star Trek are so ingrained in pop culture that it's a timeless thing.
Sure.
Like... To relate it to the conversations that we've had so far, it's Jesus Christ! I was just juggled in the middle by all three of you.
Nice.
Holy shit. Okay, anyway. The Star Wars popularity has slipped out of time.
Sure.
So
it has crossed many, many generations, much like I slipped out of time. Which is interesting, because time control was the power I chose. What if we all get superpowers based on our answers tonight?
Oh, I hope I get super speed.
Let's relive the 90s. Yeah. It's all about it. Everything in the 90s was great, right? Nothing went bad. Nothing. 56K was super. Let's all go back to that. Whoa.
A short by, I think it was College Humor or something like that. Where the video started out and it was this like dude in his 20s talking about how the 90s were awesome and that he wanted to go back there, and then a time traveler comes in and transports him back to the 90s, but then explains to him that he needs to prevent 9/11, so he needs to like try to warn people, but that won't work, so he needs to like hijack a plane and show people how dangerous planes are, and it just turned into this ridiculous parody of time travel and nostalgia mixed in.
That's crazy. Yeah. I think in the chat they are announcing their birth years. I'm an 85.
91.
97. I don't know anything.
You're so young.
The majesty of Michael Jordan playing against aliens with
Wait. Has he never seen it?
I have never, no.
Oh my God, Sally.
Yeah. You have not lived until you've seen that movie. But
come on, slam.
He did miss the era of the Super Mario Bros. Movie.
Listen, man, that movie gets so much trash. I liked that movie growing up.
Oh, no. Well, I mean, growing up, yeah, because it had bright, flashy colors.
Exactly, and that's all it needed. I don't think a lot of the things in that movie made sense, but that movie worked.
They turned Toad into a Koopa.
Yeah. That's, you know, there's an argument there.
and they turned that movie into, like, the Mushroom Kingdom was an alternate dimension where the dinosaurs never got wiped out by a meteor or something.
Yeah, and they evolved. And fungus also was intelligent because of being reverted by a machine into fungal state. Fungal people, I guess, were devolved. I'm all into it. I had no problems with that movie growing up. I loved it.
Yeah, but now you'd probably...
And it had John Leguizamo and the guy from Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Yeah.
Like, that's a great casting.
I heard this interesting fact the other day. If you guys watch Movie Fights on YouTube, they had a live panel at SDCC, and they talked about or it wasn't on that one, but it was on another one anyway. They were talking about the worst movie of the 90s, and the Super Mario Bros. Movie won out in a
bullshit.
Movie fight.
It's not that bad
because of the main fact that the director and Nintendo never made a movie ever again.
But that's silly.
They make cutscenes.
Very true.
Yeah, what do you say to that?
I will give you that one.
Oh yeah!
Watching the replay.
Oh yeah! Oh man! Oh, sorry, bumping everything. Oh man!
Well, that killed me.
That was so good.
People are trying to, like, really, dude.
Yeah, Radical Ed. Yeah, Ed Girl. I'm sorry, I always get it wrong for some reason. Radical Ed Girl definitely has the right point. The movie had great attention to detail. They knew they were crafting a reality, and I think they did a great job. It was a tough. It's a tough job, right? Any video game movie. Like, what's a good video game movie?
Lara Croft.
No.
Only because they had, like, two sequels.
Only because
that doesn't make it. Having a sequel doesn't make it good. Oh, PTC missed.
It made enough money to where the studio was like, yeah, sure, make another one. Doom was just as bad as.
Listen, yeah, and so was Lara Croft. If you're gonna start, just because a movie makes money, that movie made money because of boobs, not because of the quality of the movie.
Yeah.
Boobs are all right.
Listen, I got nothing against boobs. Boobs are great. But
what are you saying?
But I'm saying that doesn't make a movie. And that's all that made the sales.
Mm. Yeah. Porn is not considered a movie, okay?
I mean, when I watch my porn, I want the plot.
I mean, what's wrong with that? Why are we joking?
I had gout. I wanted to see what happened.
He had what?
Gout.
Ew, what porn are you watching with a dude with gout? That is a terrible porn. Sorry to anyone in the chat who has gout. I've just offended somebody.
If you're not offending somebody, you're not doing it right.
I guess there's something to be said there. Oh, damn.
I am dominating with Lucian's knives. I never do that. I never dominate with his knives.
Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I can't. I can't land. Mortal Kombat. I did enjoy the Mortal Kombat movie.
Nice.
Actually.
That was awesome, Sally.
That's a good one. RTTN the, craft.
the Mortal Kombat movies?
Yeah, well, the one, not the sequel.
Oh.
The sequel was terrible.
Yeah, I'll give you that.
But that first movie was fun.
All right, so what do you guys think about the Minecraft movie that's coming out?
There's a Minecraft movie?
Yes.
Well, I don't know anything about it yet, so what's the story here? What is it going to be?
No idea.
CG, but, or I mean, like an animated film, or is it going to be?
Well, I mean, the story's been around for years. Ever since that one dude was going to kickstart a Minecraft movie, like a live action Minecraft movie, a couple years ago. That WB shut him down or something, or Mojang, or he had plans for a movie. I'm not really sure exactly the context of everything, but so what? I think I'm gonna reserve judgment for Minecraft script writing until I play the Minecraft Telltale game.
Oh yeah, I'm curious about that way more than I am about a movie.
Yeah, Minecraft story mode. Because I mean, honestly, that technically would count as a movie to me, at least.
Yeah, yeah. Because I love
it's a narrative based game.
I love those Telltale games. They're so good.
I've played a little bit of The Walking Dead, and I know how awesome they are, but I just don't have the time to sit down and play the Telltale games.
Oh, whoa. Someone says that the Minecraft movie is going to be directed by Mac from Always Sunny.
Ooh.
That piques my interest pretty hard. That's pretty good.
Talking about All-Star...
McElhaney or whatever his name is.
talking about All-Star directors who are taking over projects... like scripts or stories that have already been in circulation. Have you heard that Steven Spielberg is going to direct Ready Player One?
Oh, yeah, I had heard that. And I'm not sure. See, first of all, I haven't read Ready Player One.
It's really, really good.
My wife has. And yeah, she's told me a lot about it.
Yeah, it's more or less Born Identity meets Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory meets The Matrix.
Yeah, with that a little bit good. Of D&D.
Yeah,
I know it's got a Syrek from Tomb of Horrors, which that instantly makes me go, oh, maybe I should check that out.
it's definitely a good book because as I'm sure that your wife has probably told you, the creator of the game was a huge D&D fan.
Yeah, now here's a dissenting opinion, which I was trying to get to. My wife actually said that it had all these references, and so she read it because, like, she loved living through the references, but she felt like the book overall really wasn't that good. And Sporksand in the chat is saying book was just a letdown. And that's what's kept me away from it.
Well, I mean, I'm very easy whenever it comes to entertainment. I'll get sucked in by anything. So,
well, yeah.
I'm definitely not the critic type, so don't take my word for anything.
Sure.
I'm probably hyping it up way too much.
Yeah. To jump back a bit, Crazy296 says, the Telltale game preview really pissed me off. I hated the voice acting and the fact that they are making a Minecraft game in general. So that's interesting. I haven't seen the trailer for it or anything, so I don't know what the voice acting's like, but I love Telltale in general.
All right, so from what I've seen, it has Captain Sparkle's level animation. It has I can't remember the voice actors or anything about the plot, but I remember the animation at least.
Well, that's disappointing. But I'll have to judge myself, I guess. You know, I'll have to watch a trailer or something. But if it is obnoxious voices or something, that could be a shame. but Telltale hasn't let me down yet. Both of the Walking Dead games were amazing. And A Wolf Among Us was a lot of fun to play through as well.
Have you checked out the Game of Thrones one?
I haven't done that one yet. The next one I'm going to do is Tales from the Borderlands.
Oh, yeah. I'm in the middle of that one, actually. I haven't played it since the second update, the second chapter, and I really want to. Because I'm a huge Borderlands fan. Jesus Christ. Okay, any RPG like that with an assortment of guns and stuff, and the comedic value of having Anthony Birch writing for it.
Oh yes, yes.
Something that I love.
Yeah, which he left after he did that stuff, so he's not going to be on any future Borderlands stuff, which is a disappointment.
Did he write for the pre-sequel? Because I haven't played that yet.
Yes, he did. Well, he wrote for the for Borderlands 2, and then he actually wrote one of the DLCs like as the main writer for it.
Well, I mean, of course, because his sister was
Tiny Tina or whatever. Yeah.
So, I mean, the whole Dungeons & Dragons thing, I'm pretty sure was from him, right?
Yep. Yep, that's the one. He wrote that one. And for those who don't know, Hey Ash, What You Playing is an amazing web series.
Oh yeah.
It's all on YouTube now. They've migrated over. And then Anthony Birch, who is the older brother from that series and slash main writer of those. I mean, he writes them with his sister, but he does a lot of the upfront work. He is working now for Rocket Jump, which is Freddie W's company. And they just got a deal for a Hulu show.
Oh yeah, is it? Oh, I don't want to mix up stuff that I've seen. But is it the one where it's like a mockumentary or a documentary about how they make shorts?
Yep, that's okay. The one, and he is the writer for it, or nice. one of the writers for it, I should say.
Yeah.
Damn. Rocked out of there.
Damn.
So yeah, Hey Ash, What You Playing is one of my favorite things on the internet for sure.
Yeah, definitely. I love her. I love the episode recently about the gamer girls. Yeah. Her becoming a gamer girl.
Was that like the end of the previous season?
Possibly. I mean, I saw it a couple weeks ago, and I think.
Oh, okay.
Not weeks, months. Oh, what?
Oh, wait.
What?
Or do you mean the social justice warrior one? No. If you're talking about the gamer girls one, that was the end of the previous season. They're on a new season now, so you've got a few new things to look forward to.
Jesus. Yeah!
What a just ridiculous assault there.
That, like, everything lined up. Oh my god, that was awesome.
That was another one.
Can I get a double? Nope, I cannot get a double. Ow.
Damn it, no one. Oh, damn it.
Oh, I should have let it go earlier. Boom.
Fuck. All right, you guys. Tia is heading out. Tia, thank you so much for playing with us. That was a ton of fun, and we'll hope to see you around soon. If anyone else, I guess, wants to jump in, we've got an open slot now. So, be more than happy to have you. I don't know how much later you guys want to play.
No, I'm good all night.
Ow. Well, I don't know about all night, but I'm down to hang out for a little bit longer for sure. My phone is blowing up like crazy.
Come on, man. You gotta get better than this. Come on, really? You're gonna walk into each one of them?
Just...
Come on.
Just gaming you. Cheap gaming. There you go. Now things are going to change.
Yep, that's it.
Look at that freeze frame.
I didn't realize I was out of jumps.
That diving smile.
Hey, Shigemori?
Rigor mortis?
Is it like time sensitive that you're trying to get it, or... Because, I mean, I could easily spring for another key if you want to jump in.
Yeah, I was assuming that's what they mean, is they don't have a key for getting on right now. That's up to you, though. I'm not going to push you to do that for someone you don't even know. We have to wait in silence to let them tell us what they're feeling, if they're feeling up for it. That'd be cool, though. Get another person in here, for sure. There would be one other, and you two don't get along. I assume he's talking back about Redbeard again. okay, so Luke Ellis Island is also saying they could get in. Hello, Luke Ellis Island. And do you actually have the game? Because if you do, we just need to friend you on Steam, and then we can invite you in. That's probably the easiest way. But if you don't have the game, it's that's the only barrier.
You can still send your friend requests.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah, Dundall on Steam or Instant Replay Live is what I'm displaying as. Whatever you guys want to friend me, that's totally fine. Pity works slowly.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and hook Shigemori up since he or she has been literally watching this whole time.
Sure. Well, then maybe we'll do Luke Ellis Island at some point shortly thereafter. We'll try to rotate in or something.
Sure.
Because we got two people asking at the same time. So we'll do Shigamori now because Beardy is just a generous person. and then we'll do the next one after.
Yeah, I definitely don't mind rewarding people who are loyal.
Man, look at you. Thank you.
You can get Luke in there. I'll sit out.
Again, I'm not asking anyone to do that, so that's up to you. Well, it looks like you've already quit, so is that meaning you need a break?
I don't need a break, but he can join.
Well, Luke,
he
if you...
He or she.
I'm going to assume Luke is a he.
All right. Shigamori, is your Steam profile pick the Bulbasaur Boba Fett?
Yeah, that's going to be a delay. Maybe we should ask in chat.
It's the Boba Fett Bulbasaur. Not the Bulbasaur Bulbasaur. Got him.
Okay, Luke Ellis added us on Steam, so let me get in there. And
okay, I just needed to make sure before I spent $12.
Right. Yeah. Don't send it off to the wrong person. let's get some people in there. Don't have the invite option. Let's go. Maybe. Is there not an invite option? That's annoying.
Well, the is there a room number, or did they take that out?
No, there are. Where is it though? Because I don't see it.
5632.
Oh, right up at the top.
Yep. So yeah, if you guys want to, while we're getting things set up here, let's do another plug for those of you who might have just joined.
Oh, sure.
I'm Redbearded Gamer. I have a hitbox stream that I do that I'm going to get into maybe once a week, once every other week, something like that. It's hitbox.com/redbeardedgamer. I also have a YouTube account, youtube.com/redbeardedgamer. And you can find me on Twitter @redbeardedgamer. But yeah, I do this kind of content. I collab with a whole lot of people. I'll give gifts out every now and again to loyal fans and loyal watchers and such. So
rock on.
And then Sally also has a YouTube channel and links if you wants to plug them real quick.
Yep. Twitch is Salamander Beats, BEATS. I'm gonna have to get back into that or start it up. My YouTube is Salamander Breath, and Steam is Salamander Breath.
Yeah.
Y'all check me out.
Do it. It's a good idea to do that.
Yeah.
And I guess I should go ahead and say, since there's a number of people here who probably don't know us from YouTube, we are Instant Replay Live on YouTube as well. We have regular guest spots, so every now and then we might have Redbearded Gamer or a Sally on over there. And we do 2 episodes a day every day on YouTube, so if people like watching this stuff, they could watch it there too. Like, comment, and subscribe, and maybe, you know,
share it. 5 stars. From way back in the day.
Oh, we got Shigamori joining. So Shigamori, actually, we'll go ahead and plug. We need to get Shigamori on the call, though, if they want to do that. Let's ask and chat.
Luke said he has about an hour. He said that in the in the game chat. And then Shig said, that he or she could join us on Skype.
Okay, cool.
And Luke as well.
Okay, great. So we need to get Skype names. Easiest way, guys. Let's see. All right, we'll start with that one. There are a number of James Neumeisters, but I'm going to guess the one that comes from the state where some of the other people I know on here are James Neumeister is the other half, Shigamori is the other half of Kraken Quake Gaming. So we've had the first half with Red Bearded Gamer, Red Beard on earlier. We have Red Bearded Gamer on currently from a different channel to make things more confusing. And now we're getting Shigamori. So, what a fun juggling match.
By the way, I normally go by Beardy, so that might alleviate.
That'll help. Yeah. We'll call you Beardy. All right. And did Luke Ellis ever say a Skype name or add me? Let's see. I don't see an ad. So, Luke Ellis, if you're hearing us, or... Okay, there we go. Same as Steam, and he's booting up Skype right now. Cool.
Yeah, I think we'll stick with stock and time with what we've been doing. It's not broke, so let's not fix it.
Sure.
Oh, Luke is level 6 with Thatch.
Nice.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, we hear you. How you doing?
Oh, sweet. Pretty good.
I don't have Luke in there yet, though.
So the first couple of minutes of this game is me just going to figure out the buttons.
Oh, totally.
Just kind of joined the game. It was like, all right, we're doing this.
Yeah, by the way, Shig, and for those who are watching who might pick this game up or had this game already, it does have controller support, and it plays a lot like Smash Bros. Like you'll get into it really quick.
Yeah, if you've ever played Smash, then you'll have some immediate just kind of reflexes.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much just 2 seconds to figure out which button jumps and which button attacks, and then you're good to go. So it says you left, Shig.
Yeah, I'm setting up the controller really quick.
Ah, gotcha.
Okay, Luke Ellis said they're having some trouble on Skype, so we'll just we'll go on for now without them on Skype, but then maybe we'll get them in on the next one if they get it up.
Just waiting on Shig to
but
bring back
yeah,
in.
We'll get Shig back in before we start, of course. Yep. All right. Well, in the meantime, PTC says, "Would you rather go on a dream vacation alone for a week, or spend 1 week with anyone on the planet, but have to stay in your hometown?"
There we go.
That is tough. 1 week in your hometown with anyone.
I'm gonna have to go with anyone on the planet.
I'm definitely leaning that way, but the dream vacation, what does that include? That could be all inclusive.
Well, I mean, my dream vacation would be in a soundproof room with a $5,000 desktop playing Just Cause 3 for a week in recording.
You dream
low. So I feel like my dream vacation is much bigger than that. That's an accomplishable dream, what you just described.
Well, I mean, after a couple of years, yeah. Then I'll have a vacation every day.
Man, that's a tough question for me, though, because... Dream vacation, right? Like, there's places I would love to go that I'll probably never be able to go at this kind of pace in my life anyway. But there are also people I would love to get to spend some time with. You run the risk of, like, spending a week with someone is enough time to, like, really not like them.
No kidding. People don't realize that if you spend 24/7 with somebody for long enough, they'll get to you.
Adam.
Oh, damn it, I blew myself up.
You don't know me.
We only spend 22 hours, it's okay.
Yeah, that critical 2-hour break is what saves you. Keeps your friendship healthy and whole.
But I know enough.
So he says a follow-up question is what is your dream vacation / who would you spend the time with if you chose that? So, gosh, I gotta...
Well, I mean, to be honest, my dream vacation would be to...
Oh, good night, Karen.
I guess it would be hanging out at the beach, just relaxing, and then catching some natural predators hockey games. I'm a huge hockey fan.
Nice. I think my dream vacation alone, because I feel like that changes things, right?
Yeah.
But it would be in some sort of, like, either like a New Zealand or somewhere else that just looks like one of those places out of a fantasy movie, you know? Yeah. Possibly Norway in the right seasons and right places, being that I've always wanted to go to Norway, but that one is kind of a realistic vacation. I may someday go to Norway, but doing something there where I'm spending that entire week just deeply invested in, like, some amazing con, right? Like, I'm there, not con, like, con artist, but like a gaming convention for tabletop gaming. So I don't LARP, but some super immersive experience kind of like that would actually be a lot of fun. If it was dream vacation levels, if it's like perfect immersion, I think I could get into that. Damn. Ooh. It.
Yeah, I'm glad that you've been talking to Nick, because I'm completely invested in figuring out these guys and his style.
I am getting my ass kicked and I'm out already. It doesn't even matter.
Yeah, I'm highly invested in figuring out these guys' play styles so that I can just completely trash them later. No offense, guys. Ow!
Crack and Quake brings up a good point. How alone is the vacation? So is my con even practical? Or am I literally going there alone? Am I in complete isolation? I assumed it meant you left alone, but, you know, whoever you meet there, you meet there.
Well, I mean...
You host your own con, and you're the only one there.
Yeah, that would be disappointing. I wouldn't be as into
talking
that.
Talking so much about cons, I got a point that I want to bring up later. But I would say that a lot of people's dream vacation would be in some kind of public place anyway. So.
Right, but I mean, it's all in the boundaries. Yeah, you're the only person you know when you get there. Yeah, and totally.
Yeah, totally, yeah. Talking about cons, have you guys... We might have talked about this whenever we collab. Nice.
That was a nice. Typical Sally throw.
even though Sally's not playing.
Sally throw.
I think we might have talked about this whenever we collabed, but Con Man. The show.
Oh yeah, yeah, yes, yeah.
Million? Yeah. Yeah.
Looking
that's
forward
gonna
to
be
it.
Amazing.
Definitely looking forward to it.
If you guys haven't heard, Alan Tudyk and Nathan Fillion, who both played characters on the hit one-season show Firefly, are making a parody show about their lives after Firefly.
Yeah, and it looks funny as can be. I didn't buy in on the Kickstarter, do you?
I think I'm going to put $5 in.
Okay, yeah, so you put something in. I'm a little ashamed that I didn't, but I just kind of... Held off.
I mean, they blew past their like 250,000 goal by
oh yeah totally
like, tenfold because like up to
and you knew they like, would
yeah it was about 3 point something million dollars. I'm gonna go with Roland this time.
But it's one of those things where like I look at a Kickstarter and I know it's gonna succeed and I'm like . If I know it's going to succeed, I'm going to get to see the episodes anyway.
Yeah.
Then, like, do I really feel like I need to invest in this? I think, Radical Ed Girl and I were talking about this recently on chat. The same exact Kickstarter and feeling of just being like, is that where I need to spend my money? Or do I need to go to a lower project that's, you know, not going to make it? Oh, Luke Ellis's Skype is working now, so let me...
Sure. I'll go into this out while you're doing that. If you had a couple of million dollars and you were well set off and then a Kickstarter like that came up and like one of the $10,000 levels was you'd get to hang out with them, the cast, for a day, would you do that kind of stuff?
$10,000 level?
Yeah, there was like a $10,000 level
Am I ever going to donate $10,000 to a project? Is that what you're asking me?
Yeah, but the perk would be that they would come and hang out with you or go to your birthday party or something. Because I think that was like a jokey type thing. That yeah, like
no,
the...
I would never spend $10,000 on that. that is not a worthy spend of $10,000 in my mind.
Well, I mean, if you had a couple million dollars and you were at where you wanted to be in your life, like you had a
I
big
would,
house and
I would like to think up. I would like to think that if I were in that position that I would be more charitable and give my money not I mean being a patron of the arts is something that I would like to do more. So conceptually I'm not against that idea, but for that kind of return, no, I'm not gonna pay someone to hang out with me, you know?
Yeah,
that feels icky to me. We got Luke Ellis on the call. How's it going, man?
Hey, it's going good.
All right, yeah. Go ahead and choose your legend, sir, and let's get in here and beat on each other. Do you?
Yeah, I mean,
Luke, we've been letting everybody promote their channels and everything. Do you have anything to promote?
Yeah, I have a few channels. I have more of an update channel, just called Luke Ellis Island.
All right. And
then I have two channels. One's a sketch channel, which is called The Walrus is Coming.
Nice.
And then a gameplay channel called The Walrus is Gaming, where we do daily uploads on that one.
All right, that'll be cool. I can't vouch for it like I've been able to do for the other guys, but could be something worth checking out.
Yeah, I put a lot of work into it.
Nice.
All right, now I'm going to get quiet so I can focus on that.
Right, yeah. Yeah, welcome to the call. Shut up.
But yeah, I would as well. I would be more charitable with money, but I would keep enough to where I could invest in some projects that I'm passionate about like that. Like,
I
mean, it wouldn't just be because I wanted to hang out with the crew for a day or pay someone to like me or whatever. It would be just the chance to actually meet those guys and talk to them and then help their projects even more than they already passed their goal. But, like, it would go towards more for them.
Yeah, I mean, being a patron of the arts, I can both respect and understand. I am not financially in a position in my life where I can do a whole lot of that is.
But I was putting the hypothetical forward of if you were at the point where
exactly. But that aside, I still, for that reward, that wouldn't be what does it for me.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there were a ton of other rewards, but still, I do get your point.
Yeah. That's not a 10,000. I mean, that's not a thing I would want, because, you know, the big thing is this whole, like, the celebrity is such a ridiculous concept, because we're all people, right? Like, no matter how cool these people are, and they certainly are, but I can't see deciding.
No, you're missing the point. They're prettier than you. Obviously, they deserve your respect.
I hang out with a lot of people who are prettier than me. It doesn't take much. God damn you and your.
Ah, jeez.
Got them Sally throws.
Yeah, he really does. Oh, I'm stunned.
Oh, got me. Yep. So here's a hypothetical for you. If you were at that financially stable part in your life where you had more than four digits in your bank account, what would you spend your money on other than charity?
I mean, certainly. Well, I guess, how did I get my money, right? Because that's partly key. Do I need to continue spending money to continue gaining money? And then, you know, am I investing in a career in some way? Potentially.
And again, you are at that financially stable part of your life.
All right, so I've already done all of that. My career is self-sustaining, and this is just free money I have. I got 10,000 liquid to just play with. Blood money, yeah. I invested in blood diamonds, and paid off really well. I am now a mogul. And I got, I've just got liquid 10 grand that I'm like, you know what, this is burning a hole in the old bank account. Let's open the wallet and see what I can spend it on. That's tough. I think I could spend 10 grand on some experience. So maybe it would be, you know what? I've kind of always wanted to run my own con. Since we were talking about cons earlier, that idea is just one of those surface ideas that, like, because we were talking about it, it now seems relevant. So I don't know if that would be my answer any other day of the week, but right now it feels like a good way to blow 10 grand.
I'd probably invest in my home a lot. Like, make it the place people want to be.
Yeah, that's cool. That's a good answer. Alright, who's the chocolate Captain Crunch here?
That would be me.
Alright. It's you and me.
Yeah, I got dropped out, and then you guys murdered the AI. Good job.
Oh, you didn't say.
I did say. I said I got dropped.
I don't listen to you.
He said, brruh, 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 dropped out.
See?
That's all he said.
It's very clear.
I heard it.
Yeah, Radical Ed Girl is absolutely right. It would be just like building my D&D cave to the extreme. myself a geek chic $10,000 table. And then that 10 grand is all gone already. I got a purple Bodvar.
Oops.
Unlock.
Well, for me, I would negotiate with Valve on getting a good chunk of the games on Steam.
Just like, how many games will 10 grand buy me?
I would actually talk to Valve directly and be like, what kind of deal can you cut me in for if I just give you 10 grand?
We'll give you the license to Steam.
PTC asks, would you rather be a master swordsman or a master marksman?
Master marksman.
Master baiter.
Nailed it.
I've always been infatuated with archery.
Yeah?
As a martial skill, yeah.
I think I would almost rather go swordsman because I can see the practical uses for marksman because it doesn't just apply to archery. It could be, you know, guns and just keeping yourself alive. But swordsman, I think I would prefer because, like, it would be a way more fun life to be like, I'm just a master choreographer for films or, you know, like, you want to meet all those cool people. Don't pay $10,000. Have a skill that's useful to them. You know, go do fight choreography on multi-billion dollar you know, entertainment industry projects. And
well, archery's on the upswing for films, it seems,
and TV with Arrow. But real quick, what's the room number? Because I got jumped out.
5632.
There you go.
I kicked out all together.
Oh man.
There you go.
I didn't want you to play.
Yeah, it seems like somebody else dropped as well.
Yeah we're down to three. Are you coming back in?
I'm trying to.
Okay.
But yeah, since you guys have been watching the stream, you guys know that I'm a big fan of Green Lantern and The Flash, but as far as marksman or swordsman, I'd have to go marksman for archery.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I'm a pretty decent fan of Green Arrow as well, but I've always been infatuated with archery.
Oh, so that's a good answer. Also, Radical Ed Girl has in the chat that Josh, her husband, would set up a video game news outlet with the money and get access to every game as a result. So that's your way around your Valve deal. You just get all the games, and also you're part of an industry, and you know you're creating things. That's cool. Creating video game news is pretty sweet. So I can get into that. That's a good answer. And PTC, I love thinking on things and rambling, so I really actually appreciate you coming in here and just throwing things at me to talk about. Well, certainly helps with the stream.
I mean, the best streams that I've had is where people do this. They just go in there and have an impromptu AMA.
Yeah, it's super helpful to have that, so thanks so much. That's kept
Can I get the room number?
Yeah, it's 5632.
All right. All right, back in.
Sweet.
Yeah, I think we're going to have to rely on Roland with his impregnable defense and, you know, noob friendliness.
Okay.
Oh, a new question from PTC. Would you rather be fluent in 10 languages or master 10 instruments?
Instruments.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Immediately nice. Instruments.
Nice.
Because I actually was in a music theory class in high school, and the question was brought up, is music a can music cross language lines, or is music relatable all around the world? And I said yes, just like mathematics is, because mm-hmm. if you hear a major chord, it's more or less a happy sound. If you hear a minor chord, it's more or less a sad sound. So you can get across your point just by playing something.
And like I'm with that too. With like Gundam style, that was like huge here in America, even though nobody knows what he's saying, you know?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I mean, it turned out that he was talking about like a lifestyle.
Yeah.
Like some kind of lifestyle in a certain area.
Poverty area, yeah. Or yeah. Whatever. Well, like a disparate, I think, class system. But, yeah, no, I mean, guys, that's pretty well thought out, Beardy. I think I have to agree. That I would have to choose. The other reason I would choose music, though, is or instruments, is because I have no musical talent, and being able to fix that magically is certainly desirable. I feel like I could learn languages if I took the time, but music is not natural to me. So
and languages as well would definitely have an impact on your life, and it would make you feel like you need to travel more, which would cost a ton of money.
Oh sure, but
that's true.
I mean, I think if I was a master of 10 instruments, I'd want to do the same thing, simply for concerts.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, if you were a master of 10 instruments, you could easily gain some...
Earn your travel fares.
Yeah, get gain some fame and earn your travel fare. And if you know 10 languages, you can't really walk up to somebody and speak a different language and be like, yeah, that'll be $10.
I'd love to see that.
I'm curious because... Radical Edgirl once again said that Josh says he would go with the languages, and I'm wondering what his reasoning is, if we can get that answer. Like, what makes learning languages a superior choice? I could see it for business, like if you're already engaged in international business somehow, then learning those would just enhance you considerably. Oh, Kraken Quake also says languages, so let's hear the logic. I could see just those because. Things being insanely, yeah, just because.
Well, I mean, I'm pretty adept at playing a couple of brass instruments, and I can play a little bit on piano, and I also sing, so I'm
ooh,
halfway
you're a
there.
Ladies man.
I'm halfway there already, so.
I play the keyboard, the computer keyboard.
Yeah, yeah.
That's all I do.
Oh, that was good.
Nice. Ooh, nice.
That was awesome.
That was me. I love it. Oh, man, we got two hammers, two rocket lances situation.
Oh, okay.
Oh, there's one less.
Yeah, I'm all the way out. So let's see. I'll keep up with... And I'm disconnected again.
Dang it.
But I'll keep up with the chat.
All right, thank you.
So, let's see. Quake said that they've tried learning instruments and tried learning languages, and I find that more instances in my daily life where I'd like to understand people. And then Radical Edgirl said linguists and translators are in more demand than musicians. Also, it is difficult to go to a foreign country and asking for a sandwich with a violin. Well, I mean, I could do it. That just sounds like a challenge.
No, those are good answers. I'd still pick music just because of my or instruments because of my complete lack of musical talent. But but those do make good arguments for it. And then we've got PTC with etymology, also a great answer. I do love knowing where those roots of words come from. So that's good stuff.
Well, I mean, diction can be an easily learned thing. It's just about talking slowly and articulating everything.
Hmm. easily learned, you would say?
Well, I mean, to me it is, because I can pick up concepts really, really easily. But I'm not sure about everybody else. But, I mean, it should be easy enough to where you can just slow your thinking down and concentrate on the motion of your mouth.
We've got a thatch battle brewing. Are you coming back in?
It's freezing up on me. I might have to just restart the game like I did a second ago.
Okay. Yeah, you want us to go on without you?
Yeah. I mean, are you guys still spectating? Or
we're in the lobby now.
Oh, yeah. Just wait a second. It won't take me too long to get back in. It's still 63 okay. Something else.
5632.
I was close.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'll go thatch. Yeah, why not?
Yeah, yeah. Thatch it up.
PTwitchC said Scrabble helps.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so
somebody, who's the room leader now? Oh,
you
is
are.
It me? Oh, okay, I'm just waiting on you to pick your guy. That's what it is.
I mean,
okay.
I dropped again.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, I was about to say that I had confirmed my character choice.
Oh, it hadn't shown up yet, and then we'll go ahead, and then you can just join and get in on the next one.
Yeah, for sure. Let me actually pull up the stream, because I didn't even have that open.
Oh, okay,
sure. The chat open.
Sure. And then you'll get the instant time travel voice chat.
Yeah, I'm just going to keep it muted and just watch it.
Ah, bombs.
For a second, I was like, wait, am I Red Thatch? I'm Red Thatch, right? It's like,
I don't know. I'm Captain Crunch.
Nice.
Oh, that's good. Not even mad on that one.
Nice.
Oh. How do you guys feel about, like, having the explosives along the weapons? Do you feel like there should be a mode where you could turn off the explosives and spike balls? Or
well,
do you
I think there
like
is,
just...
isn't there?
You Yeah, you can
is
yeah,
just,
turn off
yeah,
the...
Yeah, just turn off the atoms.
Oh, okay. I thought they were, like, one and the same.
I think no. They call them gadgets, right?
No.
Oh, is that no. The weapons?
Yeah, I think the weapons are the gadgets.
Yeah.
I don't think you can turn off the weapons, like no, the swords yeah. And...
There's okay. A toggle to turn off gadgets, so...
Well, gadgets would be the bombs and the spike balls and all
that's,
that.
That's what I was saying.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean... What do you guys think about my suggestion from close to the beginning of the stream? I don't know if you guys are watching then, but... making the gadgets have hitboxes where you could hit them back if you.
Oh yeah, no, I think that'd be an interesting idea.
That would be really cool.
Because Sally, who is the, who is more or less Kobe Bryant in this game, will just throw every single thing.
Yeah, that'd be really cool to see.
Yeah.
Because I mean that would definitely give an edge over Smash Bros. That would give a huge gameplay edge over the Smash Bros. Gameplay.
Yeah. Would it work like Nash's bat, where it like becomes more powerful once you hit it back, or would it just be like the same damage?
Oh, that would be interesting. And then you can keep on doing it?
Yeah.
Huh.
Going back to that archery, what if there was archery in here? How would that play?
I would be amazing at it, because I'm awesome at trajectories. Yeah, I seem to remember a game where you could ping pong stuff back and forth to each other, like an explosive or something. I can't remember what it is.
Damn it.
Lethal League?
No.
There have been a few games that have had similar mechanics, though. I'm trying to think of a specific example.
I mean, I'm thinking straight explosives, not just the ball, because I definitely played Lethal League.
How old would you say?
The game?
Damn.
Yeah.
Ooh. I don't know, maybe a couple years, but
I did
think,
not.
I think maybe you and me have played it, Sally.
Surprised you, actually.
I'm
in!
Alright, yeah!
Because I remember that ball game, and it was like the,
Breakout? About Breakout?
Pong?
No.
Are we talking about Pong, guys? Can we get some hardcore Pong streaming going on here?
It was the 3D court, and you could use the mouse wheel and it would rev
Oh, yeah.
Marvel Madness or something?
No, you're talking like a Windows game? Like a... like.
Towerfall? No. No, not Towerfall.
No.
Although I want to play Towerfall. I haven't even played it yet.
Yeah, I mean, I really want that to be online multiplayer. Like, just like I want Crawl to be online multiplayer. Because those games are amazing, but they're just local. And I don't have anyone around that I can play with.
Yeah, that's too bad. Sally, and you aren't local?
No, he's no. All the way across the country.
I didn't realize.
I'm not.
There you are.
No. A couple states up.
I mean, all the way across the country, pretty much.
For a rapid topic change, Radical Ed Girl says, anyone looking forward to Electra Woman and Dyna Girl?
I haven't heard anything about that, so.
So I think that's...
Dyna Girl as in no. From the Great Lakes Avengers?
I don't know. I know that there's some TV series coming out, and it's a remake, I think, of an old TV series, but kind of a... I think it's a tongue-in-cheek remake. And correct me if I'm wrong, Radical Ed Girl, but it's going to star Grace Helbig? Comedian.
Huh.
I'm not sure I know enough about it to have opinions.
Yeah, Grace, this is the first I'm hearing of it.
Grace Helbig, if she is in it, is a good comedian that I don't really get into. Like,
oh, yeah, it's gonna be, isn't it Hannah Hart and Grace Helbig?
Yeah, I think so. So you got some YouTubers.
Yeah,
taking
I mean,
over.
That's pretty much all I know about it. Is that it's gonna have Grace Helbig and Hannah Hart.
Yeah,
because I think I saw an ad on YouTube once about it.
Yeah, I'm curious. I'm curious for sure, but I think their brand of humor, it's not bad. Certainly, like I have nothing against it. Jeez, somebody got wrecked between us.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been owning over there in the corner. You guys have just been walking into my animations.
Oof.
I don't know. I'm not crazy about it. Like, in the way that I'm not like, it sucks. Oh, fuck you. Am I alive? Oh, there
so,
I am.
So talking about YouTubers and movies, has anyone seen Ant-Man?
Yeah.
I have not seen it yet.
I can't remember her name, but there's a YouTuber cameo at the very end, like right before Stanley.
Is she cameoing as a character with any significance, or?
No, she's not.
She's. I don't really want to spoil the movie, but where they're like talking about,
the after
credit scene.
Yeah,
right?
It's at the very end of the movie, but they're setting up for, Civil War kind of.
Okay.
So, I mean, it's not really spoilerish, unless you didn't know that there was a Captain America Civil War movie coming out.
Yeah. What?
What? But yeah.
What news is this?
She just plays some random dude's girlfriend as they were explaining a whole train of people that led back to a certain character.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just really funny, because the way that they did the recaps or storytelling in that movie
was awesome.
Yeah, they had the one actor do all the voices for it, and then they had the other actors come in and lip sync.
Nice.
Yeah, it was really funny.
I really liked that whole movie. Just that it was like a superhero heist movie. Like,
oh yeah, definitely.
On.
Yeah,
so cool.
I definitely want to see it. I've heard it's like the lower impact Marvel movie, right? Like all of the others felt. Like better movies than this one, from just what I've heard.
Well, I mean, the thing is that this one isn't as interconnected as everything else. This one isn't trying to set up anything during the movie.
It's like a self-contained story, but I would say it's in my like top five of the newer Marvel movies.
Yeah, Phase 2?
Yeah.
Definitely, yeah, of course.
Is there a way to mute an IM conversation in Skype? Because I'm getting blown up.
Yeah. You just need to go into the Skype settings, go into audio or something like that, and one of the checkboxes is messages and notifications.
Oh, okay.
I turned that off a while ago.
Yeah, I don't use it enough to know these things, but I'll go ahead and do that now, because I'm getting... hit pretty hard. I right know.
You wanna play this game? I'll play this game.
I'll leave you guys to talk here for a second while I dig through options.
So yeah, let's see. Out of any superpower, which one would you guys have, Luke and Shig?
Out of any superpower, honestly, just flight would be so convenient, but I guess telekinesis kind of gives you that and more.
Yeah, that's
so more or less the Magneto status.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much do whatever the hell you want. Hey, cool, you can fly, so can I, and also move things with my brain. I mean, I don't see any downsides there.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet, for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, that's a really good one. I would say either that, or I would like to talk to animals. Like, I think that would just be really cool to see, like, how they view the world and everything.
They're probably really dumb.
Probably, yeah.
I mean,
dolphins.
I would want to have the Aquaman style, where I would push my
temples and then
my
circles.
I would like push my impressions or my
push your will on them.
Okay. And then have them do my bidding. People don't give Aquaman enough credit. He is one of the characters in the DC universe that could easily go toe to toe with Superman because he's of magical origins.
He's definitely not as bad as people say he is.
Yeah, like he's got super strength. Like he's probably a little less strong than Superman, but
yeah.
Plus, he has martial skills as well, and he has a whole army behind him that he can control, like army of Atlanteans and army of aquatic creatures.
And he has a truck that he carries an octopus and a shark around in.
No, not really. Does he?
Yes. Yeah. In one canon.
I need to turn off all of these notifications.
Okay.
Well.
Everybody, go easy on Taurus.
No, I'm good. Don't worry about it.
I'm trying to pick up the bomb.
I just noticed that I was also getting notifications in the corner of the screen, like for Skype. So I had to kill that. But I'm good. I'm back.
Okay. Just want to make sure because.
It's all good, man. And also like. What is losing, right? Big deal. It's about the hanging out that I'm here for.
Yeah.
I'll lose all I need to lose.
Well, I mean, I'm in it for the win. Okay, I'm in it for number one.
Like, what's the point of
pro gamer.
Oh.
Oh, shit. No, Taros.
Nope. Bye.
All right, where am I? There I am.
I know the animation for Lucian too well for you guys to go up against me.
Everyone team up on him.
Okay. All right. Honestly, if you guys want to do that next round, put teams on, then have me on one team and you guys on the other.
Oh man, you're asking for it.
Oh, I'm all for it, man. Because watch this. Boom. Are you guys all teaming up on me now? Is
yes.
That what it is?
Yes.
I'm just hitting whoever's closest.
Yeah, I'm just hidden.
Oh.
I'll admit that I was aiming for you.
Oh. Okay, that's me. Maybe I bit off more than I can chew.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Damn it. Couldn't grab that edge.
Nope.
Who has mentioned wild thornberries here? What's going on with that?
Smasher!
I do not want to die yet.
I think all of us just had a moment of silence.
Oh, yeah?
Just concentrate.
Like, wait a minute. Let's play this game.
Boom. Oh. Okay, bye.
Ooh. All right. Cool.
Oh. Okay.
Shit.
Oh, nice throw. I didn't even see it coming. All right. Boom. Ooh. Okay. All right now. Okay, I get it.
No one likes a boaster.
Oh, that was a great one-liner before you.
Yeah, right?
Ah, shit.
That couldn't have played out better, actually.
Oh, quite pleased.
Yeah, you...
I don't know, how do you guys do those cool things with the guns?
I
was like, the whole last game, like, how do you do cannonballs?
Oh, right, yeah, yeah.
Are you using a controller or the keyboard?
I'm using a controller.
Okay,
Xbox style?
Or, yeah, mm-hmm. Xbox or PlayStation?
Xbox.
Okay, B, and then any direction.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll do different effects. And some of them have to charge up, so, like, they're not always the right time to use them.
You can charge them up for better effect, but if you let them loose early, they'll do damage.
Yep, that's a good point.
That's for every attack.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so do you want to do teams? Because I'm still up for it.
Oh, okay. All right, let's do it.
Everyone against me.
Oh, it auto splits it.
Well, then go down to the players. Oh, well, I got kicked, but go down to the players, and you should be able to switch their teams.
Wait, what?
I don't see how that works.
Do you want me to host?
Sure. Can I pass it?
I got kicked out, so I'm gonna just make a game. Room number is
2188.
2188.
Oh. Custom. All right. Let's let you handle that. Well, Redbeard and Joe and their Brandon Sanderson novels. Those guys.
Reading a little bit of it too.
Oh really?
Mistborn was a lot. I really enjoyed Mistborn. The first one was the best, but because you didn't really know anything that was going on, so like everything that happened was so cool. And then in second and third book, they're like, and then they did this, and then they did this, and like, okay, but nothing's like new and surprising and cool. Just kind of cool.
Oh, welcome back to you.
So yeah, I told you wrong. Up in the top right of the screen, there was a button that said players, and you can click on that. And...
Oh, okay. All right. Well, as long as it's set, it's cool. I don't care.
Yep.
All right. fun. Quit buzzing.
Oh, I'm going to hate this. Why did I choose to do this?
Because you like losing, apparently.
Well, you guys need to score off of me. I only need to... I'm only needing this.
Oh, shoot, it's time. Okay.
Whoops, my bad. I should have put it on stock, but this will work.
Yeah, this will just destroy you a lot.
Actually, he has an advantage. We only have one target to kill.
Oh, that's true, actually. That's interesting. I wonder how that'll play.
You guys salty?
I love that taunt so much.
Yeah, I haven't gotten any taunts yet, and I'm a little disappointed.
Oh! Ow!
Yeah, this is going to be your whole game. It's just like, how long can I avoid them?
Not necessarily. All I needed to do was just get that one weapon, and now I'm good. I got my guns.
We're all so intense. Oh my god. It's like...
I didn't think it was going to be this hard.
For us, yeah.
Okay.
For us, it's like, man, if we lose 3-on-1, if we lose, this is horrible. Like, we're never going to be able to show ourselves on the internet again. But for you, it's like winning would be such a huge thing. Like, the drive to win must be massive.
Yeah, it's God status here. I just want to win so bad. Oh, God. It was a blue orgy on me.
Blue orgy?
It sounds like a really cool band name, actually.
I was going to say it sounds like a band name. Like I guess there was a band called Orgy back in like the 90s. So...
Oh, God.
Oh, that bomb almost nailed you.
Oh, yeah.
God, that would have been great.
That would have hurt.
There we go. Wow. There we go.
We're so good at this game. Look at us. Win 3-1.
I mean, really? Jesus. Whoa!
Okay.
Tied up.
Oh, no. Shit! shit! And then you killed yourself. What happened
there?
I made
it fair for us.
I'm still alive.
Didn't you die?
I got kicked.
You've been disconnected.
Oh,
okay.
Damn!
I win!
No. Win. Damn, though.
Yeah, we were tied up whenever I...
Yeah, because you got that double KO. That was amazing.
Yep.
That sucks, though.
I knew my animations, and whenever I had you guys chasing me to the edge, I knew I had you guys.
Now we're just beating up NPCU.
Be nice. Come on.
No.
I don't know what's going on, but I'm having to restart Brawlhalla every time I get kicked.
Yeah, it's no good, man. Man. That's so disappointing because that was going well.
Yeah, because, I mean, we were tied up in how much time was left?
2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Yeah, I mean, that was a lot of time for a lot to change, but.
Oh, I'm back in.
Sorry.
I'm back in.
Yeah, but it's like, you know.
All right, well,
you've died so many times. You walked off the head.
That's
you
all
think,
we have left.
Give me a minute.
Yeah, right?
Exactly. Just give me a minute. That's all I need.
All right, sure. Here, I'll just sit over here and let you handle a little two-on-one action.
Nope. Thank you.
Oh,
that's
whoa,
one.
Okay.
If you come over for me, bets are off.
Okay. All right, well, that's it. It's 5 to -4, so.
Yeah, we'll do it again. We'll do it again. Oh, look, I helped. I'm helping.
Now it's only 2 to -4. I only need to get 6 points in the next 14 seconds.
You can probably do it.
I believe in me. Oh!
Nice.
Wow! 4. Oh.
Look at that! Nice.
Whenever I heard the countdown, I knew I had to do it.
Yeah, that was great. All right, let's do it again, though. We'll try to get a real one in before you get disconnected again.
Okay, what's the room number for you guys?
2188. 2188. Yeah. Is the chat enjoying this, by the way? Is this fun? I don't know. Watching three people beat up on someone? Oh, did it,
what?
It resettled the teams, but I can go into players now.
Here
we go.
I need to somehow...
Oh. You're...
There we go.
Okay.
I had to reset it to my controller.
Okay.
After many a time of searching of this game, I finally found it.
One.
Super Ball.
Oh, is that the one that I've seen on Reddit a bunch?
Okay.
Like driving a car and getting a soccer ball?
No, it's a different one, but it's still soccer. And no, that's not it. Good job, Sally.
It is it. That's
not
what I was talking about.
It's, yeah. Oh, that might have been the one that you were talking about. That's not the one that I was talking about.
Oh.
Okay.
But Super Ball is amazing, though. It's free to play, and it's kind of like...
Hold on, guys. We got people leaving the chat, so let's say goodnight to those folks, and we'll probably go ahead and make this the final thing
goodnight,
we do
Bill.
For the night. Yeah, goodnight, PTC and Radical Ed Girl.
I guess.
And this will, like I said, this will be a good ending point, so... Yeah, this is it. Everything's on the line now, guys.
It'll be the best ending point if he wins.
Oh, yeah. Well, either way.
Okay, alright. All right.
I can't believe you didn't play Lucian, though.
I'd switch it up on you guys, because I know Lord Brax's animations as well.
All right.
Giving us the mix-ups.
Yeah. Just got to keep you guys on your toes. Can't be easy twice in a row. Oh. There we go. Nope. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was good.
All right, watch out for bombs. They do hurt us. Friendly fire is on for bombs, apparently.
Nope.
Right, well played.
All right.
Yeah, let's just stun lock him to death.
Seems
Thank
like
you.
A fair fight.
Ah, shit, I killed myself.
Thank you.
Whoops.
Oh, nice. If I could have gotten that final animation off, I would have had both of you. Nope. Okay.
There we go. You just...
Yeah, because I'm at full health. I can afford it.
All right.
Why not, I guess.
Gotcha. Okay. All right, bye.
Ooh! No!
That's one down.
Oh, he's back, though. We should have changed it to stock, but...
Gotcha. Gotcha. Oh, okay.
Hey, Beardy. He's got you.
I'm keeping up with you guys, though. You have to give me that.
Yeah, oh, I mean, considering. Yeah.
Thank you. All right, then. Okay. All right.
I mean, you asked for this.
Bring the A game.
Woo!
Bye.
Oh, we've all gone like
that was
totally.
Good. Oh, the save.
Okay. Nice, nice.
Hey, I'm living. It's good. I'm living.
Three Stooges moment. Whoop, 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 whoop. Man. Rocket lances are crazy good. That's the reason I like Roland, is having that rocket lance.
Yep.
Ah, we're tied. This isn't good.
Nah, we'll be alright. We got him.
Nope.
Well, we don't have that much time left.
It's gonna go into over. Overtime. Oh! Oh!
Oh! What?
Oh my god!
Mash! Oh. Well oh done, god. Luke Ellis. Oh, yeah.
All I had to do was evade.
That's the highlight of my Brawlhalla
that
career
was
right there.
So good.
Win.
So good.
Oh, good job, guys.
That was a lot more intense than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
This game has its moments.
Oh, that was amazing. That's the perfect ending. It thought we were going to go into overtime. You nailed it on second one. I mean, amazing. So I think this was a perfect night, guys, and this is a perfect place to end it. Let's do one more round in case anyone is rotated in or out on the chat for plugging yourselves. In fact, anyone in the chat, by the way, if you want to plug, you guys can go ahead. Just all dump links in the chat. Let's go ahead and do it. So, and go ahead and say them if you guys are on the call too, so that way anyone. I'm going to put this up probably on YouTube at some point, so.
Okay, yeah. Just again, Luke Ellis Island, The Walrus is Coming, and The Walrus is Gaming.
All right, Red Bearded Gamer on Hitbox, Twitter, and YouTube.
Salamander Breath on YouTube, Salamander Beats on Twitter.
All right.
Crack and Quake Gaming on Twitch.
I'm sorry. I almost forgot you. I'm so sorry. Yes.
I'm important.
Yes, you are. You absolutely are. And this has been Instant Replay Live. Thank you guys all so much for hanging out and for being a part of this totally impromptu night, and it was a blast.
Yeah, thanks for having me on.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Hey, you made the night at the end there, too. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end everything here. So thank you again.
Really kick it.
Kick Yo, it. Plans, free stroke, Sonic Golf.
Sonic Golf?